Good afternoon.
So why do you see an urban mobility expert and a very tiny firm, because I'm an independent, wearing a Sheldon-like dress here in the afternoon? Because I truly believe the big bang moment in urban mobility has arrived. And for those of you who thought what's next after Uber, here's your answer. Why do I say big bang moment? After big bang, what happened? The universe expanded. Now, with Beckin protocol, we can get the network expanded. When the network expands, the true magic happens. What do I mean by that? Today's Namayatri, tomorrow it's Metro, the day after it's BMTC, and Rido, and whatnot. What does that mean? A seamless experience, so-called multimodal stitching, is no longer what you call as an on a textbook or on a PowerPoint presentation, and that's why I don't have a PowerPoint presentation. We actually have enabled on an open mobility network, an open source, built on an open source software by JustPay, a brand new app called Namayatri. Why is it unique? It simply removes the middleman layer. I think there is something called as a consumer surplus. What we realized in India is, in urban mobility, there's such a huge fat consumer surplus, and also perhaps in New York, based on the numbers I heard. Why should just discovering a driver to take a ride make you pay so much fat commission, especially in an internet-enabled world? So that's the simplest question. So behind all this magic, my topic today is actually digital cooperative. What do you mean by that? All this technology is great, fun, enables that, empowers that. But under the hood, what you need to understand is the cold technology has to work within the envelope of societal emotions and societal acceptance. And how do you build that consensus at society level? And that's where digital cooperatives come. This morning we heard two words, a very interesting stuff, and that's the term I will use for explaining what do we mean by cooperative. It's at UIVR. Only when you and I come, we become a we can have an interaction, and we can reimagine. And that's exactly what happened in Namayatri. So three principles as to why Namayatri is a success today. I say it's a success because if you see the numbers, which you'll see shortly, it's something which the incumbents today, the so-called aggregators, took years to achieve and burnt a lot of VC money in fancy PowerPoint presentations, in fancy hotels like this perhaps, many times. So, but then this was achieved purely by the fuel of community and the passion of the stakeholders. So three principles which I want all of you to carry today if you want to build a digital cooperative. The first element is constructive conversations. Only when you have constructive conversations, you can bring inclusivity. What do you mean by inclusivity? Everyone should be heard. Just because I know C++ or Python, I can't say I know everything. The user will decide, or user will simply use what I give. So let me come back to Satya, because these are all earthly stuff. So I have to leave my Sheldon-like aloofness. That's what I advocate to all technologists. Leave aloofness. Don't think you're very smart because you can solve a code in 2 seconds or 2 minutes, or you can configure an algorithm. No. If you can't get society and your stakeholders along, no matter how good your product is, it's bound to fail. So constructive conversation, first principle. How did that happen in Namayatri? 2 years ago, I was with the government as their chief technical advisor, and I was heading a group called Alternative Mobility Group. That's why I met Sujit Nair over there. He explained to me the principles of Beckin and the possibilities of open mobility. I was excited. I said, hey, this is great. But then, government being government, you can't get traction. Early last year, I came away from the shackles of government, got a lot of latitude, and say, okay, how can we really actualize this concept? The auto driving community was the first thing which I chose, or because that was ripe for innovation. They felt they were driven to what we call as slavery almost by the existing app operators. So let me pause here for a while. So why should we meet auto drivers? Because they wouldn't know about technology, they wouldn't know about software. But they know one important thing. What's it to be interacting with a customer on the ground every day? What does it take to negotiate with the customer to go to A to B and explain to him, hey, the government mandate fare is unfair. That's why I demand that extra 10 rupees. That's why I demand this extra 20 rupees. And interesting stuff came here. Just imagine if you go and hail an auto, and if the auto wall asks you, give me 10 bucks extra, depending on the mood of the driver, you say, why are you asking extra? Why don't you come at the government price? But on an app, you will be happily able to pay 20 rupees, 30 rupees extra without even having a physical interaction. Why is it so? So that was it. Two problem statements came in. The drivers felt their agency was lost. And then the trust between the driver and the rider was also lost because of pricing opaqueness. So with these two problems, we approached JustPay, requested them, can they build an app which will address these two pain points, the driver agency and pricing transparency? And like Vimal earlier said, that true empathy came from that team. A huge shout out to JustPay team, guys. Yeah, me too. I think I don't know how many times Daya, Sachin, Hari, and others would have got UI lessons from Patabi, who basically said, this is how the app should look. This is the color it should be. This is how the workflow should be. And took the credit of JustPay. They listened, they understood, they empathized, and they built a great app. Within 4 months, it's a rage. So that's constructive conversation. And the second one is what I already explained, which is basically called collaborative co-creation. You can't sit on your ego. I'm an UI designer. I got a degree from MIT. I know best. When Patabi says it's green, it's green. That's the way I look at it. Because he's the user at the end of the day. Who am I to tell it should be green or yellow? So that constructive conversation should lead to collaborative co-creation. And now we are actually in the third element, what I call as that community contribution. So JustPay has rightly asked the community several hard questions in mobility. Can't solve it alone. Guys, come on, tell us. Not just in technology, also in behavior. Why does a driver refuse a ride? Why does a driver be arrogant? All these are questions we have to address as a society, as a community. So three principles, please remember that thing: constructive conversations, collaborative co-creation, and then community contribution. With that, actually, I invite my good friend Rudramurthy onto the stage to explain to you, all of you, the impressive statistics which Namayatri has clocked up over the last 4 months. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Rudramurthy. I am an auto driver and the General Secretary of Auto Rickshaw Drivers Union, Bangalore. We are very happy that the just 4 months we have achieved a lot. Namayatri connect drivers and customer directly. No middleman here. Customer get choice and driver has autonomy. Namayatri is a community-led app. The drivers will be focused building the community trust. We are open, transparent about our performance. Please see our dashboard. Complete trips, 4 months in 4,90,000. And registered drivers, 45,000. Registered customer, 4,41,000 in 4 months. Please watch this, the short video on the how to get her.
I think we'll see a short video. The numbers in that are quite old. That's for 3 months ago. The dashboard is live, transparent, and please feel free to take a look and participate in the hackathon which JustPay is organizing.
May I call this?